I look into the future, my darlings, and for you I see something grotesque. It will sicken and disgust you. It's me! Tonight's tale is a sickening stab at suspense about a gold digger who wanted big bucks to buy baubles and bangles. Look out, Kathy. I see you just might buy the big one.
Madame Vorna? Well, I heard you could tell the future.
She heard correctly, didn't she, Trotsky?
Well, I don't believe in this stuff, but I thought if it didn't go over my lunch hour, you know, what the hell?
Yes, darling, what the hell? The fee is $20. You pay in advance?
$20. So what do you use? Tarot cards?
I have what people call the second sight. I use myself and you.
I read your vibrations.
Sit down.
My what?
Imagine that I am an empty vessel, and your psychic energy, your spirit, fills me up. Shall we? You are a working girl, aren't you? A secretary. Wasting your life away. Type, 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 type. But that's not the plan, is it? All your life, you have desired to marry well, to marry for money, but your chance never came. So you keep working and hoping to meet Mr. Right. Or should I say, Mr. Rich?
Not bad.
Well, today, you lose your job.
Forget it. My boss is out of town, so there's no way I could get fired. Not today. You just made a big mistake.
In this area, I don't even make small ones. I tell you more. By the end of today, you have a new job.
You know what? You're nuts. My lunch hour is almost up. I'm out of here. Thanks for nothing.
Trotsky, get over here. Trotsky, vieni qua. Get off.
Sally, Madame Vorna was a total waste of time.
She was a real quack.
She went into this bizarro act and spotted out that Clayton was gonna fire me today. I told her that asshole's not even in town.
Actually, Miss Finch, that asshole came back unexpectedly.
I'm sorry, Mr. Clayton.
No, Miss Finch, I'm not the kind of thin-skinned boss who gets upset at being called a nasty name. I'm not. However, this time card here indicates you went to lunch at 12.
Yes, sir.
You know we allow only 1 hour for lunch here.
Of course, Mr. Clayton, I'm aware of that.
Well, you're fired, Miss Finch. It's now 1:25. Pack up and get out now.
You are not laid off. You're fired. You understand? Oh, no, you're totally irreplaceable. We'll probably have to close down. Where will I ever find another waitress? Hey, you! Hey!
What, are you talking to me?
You want a job?
Okay, so you were right. I did get fired. But it was because of your stupid clock. It's slow.
Well, so it is. But you weren't unemployed for long, were you, darling?
No, I wasn't.
Every exit is an entrance someplace else. Right, Trotsky? There is a new wind blowing for you. I see a great deal of money coming into your life someday. Trust me, darling. But first, I see a man in black. And you are in white next to him. It is your wedding.
Nice. Can you tell me a little bit more about the money?
I'm sorry, darling. That man will not be wealthy at the time of your marriage.
Oh, well, then forget about it. I'm not gonna marry any jerk unless he's loaded already. And I'm talking big money. A yacht, a mansion, furs, diamond rings, mink coats.
Boots and coats. What about love?
Oh, yeah. That's important, too.
Not to you. You love money, don't you, Kathy?
How would I know? I've never had any.
Soon after you are married, your man will inherit money. A great deal of money. It will come to him from someone near and dear to him. After he inherits the money, he will die. Violently.
You mean I'm gonna be a widow? A rich widow?
You will meet him tonight. A large man will make his approach.
I'm ready.
You're waiting for tonight's feature attraction, Miss Nude, Nebraska, 1948. Let's put your hands together for Miss Aura Lee.
Kind of generous, Al? It's more like stupid and stingy. Give me two stingers and a scotch straight up.
What do you think these guys come in here for?
I know, I saw the sign outside. It said big tits, not big tips. Al, look at this guy who just walked in. Jesus, is he huge?
Which guy?
Which guy? How can you miss him? He's so big, he probably has his own zip code.
Oh, you mean the full-size guy? Not your type, huh?
I don't even think he's of my species.
But he's one of our best and brightest, so bite your tongue and go to work. We take care of our customers, sweetheart.
Okay, Al.
Yeah.
So what'll it be?
I have a Rob Roy.
Okay. Is this something else?
Date tonight. After you get off work.
Well, no problem on the drink, pal, but no way on the date.
Hey. Are you playing hard to get?
No. Just try impossible to get. Hey, Al. One Rob Roy for the fat boy.
Coming up, sweetheart.
I'm the kind of guy, I just don't take no for an answer.
And how about never? Like, no way, not for all the money in the world.
See, the thing is, you move me, baby.
Get serious. Allied van lines couldn't move you.
It's okay. Just make a joke. I know I'm a little overweight.
A little overweight. Yeah, and Hitler's a little anti-Semitic. And Eisenhower's a little bald. And the Pope's a little Catholic.
Hey. Come on. Hey. What are you doing, baby? You can't escape it. We got a special connection between us. We're gonna be together. It's destiny.
Madame Vorna! You gotta tell me that fat, disgusting creep, he's not the man I'm gonna marry.
You were rude to him, weren't you? Come on, take it easy. Sit down.
He's a pig. And his face. And oh, God, the breath. Who's the real guy? You gotta tell me.
That is the real guy. He's the one you will marry, the large man I told you. I see everything. He's the one who will inherit the fortune after you're married. But listen, I told you shortly after you're married, he will die a violent death. I told you that. But don't worry about it. Have an animal cracker. Eat. Trotsky swears by them.
Sally, I just don't think I can go through with it.
Why not? Madame Vorn has been right about everything else, hasn't she?
Yeah, but this guy, he's just too grotesque to look at. Let alone do it with. Jeez, he'd probably smother me.
Oh, come on, would you cheer up? Marry the guy. I mean, didn't Vorna say it was going to be a short marriage?
Yes, my darling. Soon he inherits the money, then he dies. Violently.
Hmm. Did she say how?
She didn't say exactly.
Maybe he's like a hit by a car, you know? Like a hit-and-run driver comes along, smashes him, spreads him all along the road.
He is so big. I'm telling you, he's huge. Would take like a truck, a big old Mack truck, just to flatten him. I got better. I could see him sitting at a big old table full of food, just stuffing his big old fat face. And then he starts to choke on a big old piece of meat. And he starts gagging and spewing food. And his eyes start to bulge out, and they're watering, and his veins are popping out.
Go for it, Cap. You gotta go for it.
Say, nurse, I think you've got a patient.
Hey, baby.
What's your pleasure?
Are you busy tonight? Because I was thinking if you got off early.
I don't.
Hey, baby, give me a break. What night ain't you busy?
I'm busy every night.
Yeah. You too busy for dinner. And dancing. The works.
I don't think...
Shh. You feel that.
Get your drink. It's a Rob Roy, right?
Right.
Say, I don't even know your name.
Your date, Mr. Charlie Marno. And I'm pleased to meet you. I love Chinese food. Except for one thing.
You feel like eating again 20 minutes later?
How do you know that? I'm pretty light on my feet.
Yeah. Wish you were light on my feet.
I'm sorry?
I said you're such a delight to me.
Thank you. Yeah. Here, I got
this. Okay.
Okay, well, I had a great night.
Yeah, me too. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
can't wait for tomorrow, babe.
Why is that, Charlie?
Because I get better looking every day. Okay. What do you think of my new suit?
Well, it's you.
Yeah. See, I saw it on the rack, and it just said...
Charlie Manno.
You really know me, don't you, babe? And after only a couple of dates, it's wild. We are meant for each other. Okay. Look, I ain't got much now. But I got good prospects, and I'm crazy about you. So will you marry me?
That's an awfully big question, Charlie. I mean, I don't know anything about
you. You know I love you.
But your background, your family, you know, I mean, what if something were to happen? There was an emergency. I mean, is somebody that could help us out, you know, like a brother or an aunt. Somebody who's rich.
Rich. Well, there's just my uncle. He owns a factory. He's worth a lot. A lot. I ain't asking him for nothing.
Hey, I'm sure you won't have to. Yeah, Charlie, I'll marry you.
Do you take this man, Charlie Marno, to be your lawful wedded husband? Sickness and in health, the richer and poorer. In death, do you part with him?
I do. Till death do us part.
Kathy. Come on, baby. What's taking you, sweetheart? Come on.
Start without me.
Yeah, well, I may have to. I don't know how much longer I can hold out. Come on, baby.
And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven, I'm in heaven. And the cares that hung around me through the week seem to vanish like a gambler's lucky streak when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven, I'm in heaven. And the cares that hung around me through the week seem to vanish like a gambler's
lucky
dream.
Yeah.
When we're off together,
is this a spa?
Oh, I love to climb a mountain and to reach the highest peak.
How are your cornflakes?
Great, honey.
And next?
Great, honey.
All right, here's your dessert.
Oh, jeez. Oh, I love to go out. I love married life. In the
river. It's rich, isn't it?
But I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek.
Honey, don't forget my BVDs.
Dance with me. I want my arms about you. The charm about you will carry me through to heaven.
I have a headache.
Again? Oh, will you forget that aspirin? Let me give you a dose of extra strength, Charlie Marno.
Charlie, come on. Say, Charlie.
What?
Have you heard from your uncle? You know, the rich one with the factory. Yeah.
Nah, why would I hear from him? He's out west with his family.
Family. God damn it, Charlie. Why didn't you tell me he had family?
What's the big deal?
Big deal? Are you nuts? Are you out of your fucking mind? Are you crazy? What's a big deal? It's only my goddamn fucking future, that's all. Shit.
And three,
I've spent 3 months with this law because of you.
Five, and It's insane. It's crazy. He's never gonna inherit any money. He's just a fat, penniless pig. That's all he'll ever be. So, the honeymoon is over. You don't get it, do you? Look, I'm through with the both of you. I mean, I'm not wasting any more of my time or my money. I'm finished. Done. It's over. Look, you're just a jerk, a phony. Just stupid. You know what? It's garbage. Just garbage.
He will inherit the money. And then he will die. Vorna is right. Vorna is always right.
Hold it! Cameras! Come on! Quiet! Now, quiet, quiet, everyone, please, quiet. Young lady, congratulations.
For what?
Well, you are the Hudson Automac chain's 1 millionth customer. What is your name, please?
This is Kathy Marno.
Well,
what's going on?
This is Marno. Just a moment, I'm writing your name on this check here. Mrs. Kathy Marno. The Hudson Automat chain takes great pleasure in presenting you, our 1 millionth customer, with a check for $1 million.
Kathy, hey, Matt, you hit it big.
Madam Vaughn is a dumb bitch.
Over here.
What?
It's a thrill to be rich.
You're married. What's your husband going to say about this cool million?
I can't wait to get home and tell him all about it.
Yeah.
$1 million.
Yes, you did.
Kathy, is that you?
Yes, it is. You fat, disgusting slob.
Madame Vorta was wrong. I got the money and you didn't. I've had my last dose. Charlie Marno. And thank God.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you, you creep. I don't need you anymore. I'm moving out. No more smelling that stinking sewer you call a body. I'm out of here. Thanks for 3 months of nausea.
No.
Keep your goddamn clothes. I'll never get your putrid odor out of them anyway. And I got plenty now. Plenty.
Count
us buy new stuff. Goodbye.
Kathy. You can't just walk out on me. We love each other.
I loathe you, Charlie. Every day with you is like an eternity in hell.
Oof.
And I never felt it. Now get your grubby mitts off of me. We go. Hey, and you want some advice, Charlie? Eat a salad once in a while. And take a bath.
Kathy. One last thing.
What?
I can't have you. Nobody can.
I'm not gonna be like that, Charlie. What are you doing? Just take it easy. It's okay. Put the knife down. Down. Charlie, put the knife down now.
Okay.
Charlie, put the knife down. Charlie, put the knife down. Okay. Yeah.
Put it down. Charlie! Nobody can. If I can't have you, nobody can. If I can't have you, nobody can. If I can't have you.
Kathy Finch was a lonely girl who wanted money and love and found Charlie Marnow. She married him for she heard he would inherit a fortune and then die. Well, Charlie Marnow did inherit a fortune from Kathy Finch after he murdered her. This is Ernie Kepros live at the state penitentiary, where the priest has given the last rites and Charlie has eaten his last meal, which we understand is the largest any death row prisoner has ever had. They're about to close the blinds. This is that was something, a violent end for a violent man. I'm Ernie Kepros, live at the state penitentiary, where the priest has given the final rites and Charlie has eaten his last meal. Today we'll bring a close to
the door is open.
The brutal murder of Kathy Marnow, the man who paid for this tombstone, did so with the fortune he inherited from her. That was something, eh?
Are you Madame Vorna?
Yes, darling.
I heard you can tell the future.
For a violent man.
She heard correctly, didn't she, Trotsky? The fee is $20. Pay in advance.
Poor Kathy. She did buy the big one. And that Charlie, what a cut-up. Still, he wasn't sad in the end. You see, when Charlie got his just desserts, he requested seconds. And now, I predict the future. Next week, you'll be in the same time, same place, same station, for another hideous, hateful hall of horror.